Hello, friends in Facebook, friends in Mass Action Demand, friends in YouTube, and friends all over the world that I have. I just wrote this little note that I'd like to read to you today. I just wrote it a few minutes ago. It comes from the heart, and it's about chemtrails in Canada. Any of us who has ever fought for a cause knows that government leaders rarely ever listen to those they are supposed to represent. For instance, in my struggle to get a response regarding, an official response regarding chemtrails, Prime Minister Harper has never responded to my several emails regarding why we have stratospheric aerosol geoengineering happening over most Canadian cities almost daily and for a long time, as many of you know. Why the silence? Why the non-response? Why the secrecy? I will not let this matter rest till I get an answer. Meanwhile, I have been interviewed on 3 radio stations, each time 1 hour, regarding this troubling activity up in Canadian skies. The radio audience liked to hear what I had to say, and I am now scheduled to speak in more radio stations, even in the United States. I am also right now in serious discussion with a Toronto-based publisher, Canadian publisher, to publish a full-color special edition newspaper only on the topic of chemtrails from cover to cover, and as chemtrails in Canada to be distributed in Canada. Finally, but most importantly, I have successfully tested a new alternative to parliamentary protest, something very peaceful, but very, very powerful, I believe. It's been tested. Something I intend to launch on the 1st of May 2001, coming up in just a few weeks. This should get national attention, even if the mainstream media refuses to acknowledge or cover it. I have full faith that this fun and functional idea will work, and I now call on all those who are also who also want to have this official response from our government on why we have chemtrails in Canada, to try this new system out. And it's a system that is simple, sound, safe, and I believe very sure. Thank you from your friend Sylvain.